Santa Claus really exist? Is God real? Do aliens prevail? Ghosts, vampires, witches, wizards, mermaids, unicorns, time machines? Do they all exist in reality? All these doubts concerning the veracity of numerous notions trying to solve a puzzle of paradox are all revolving around the abstraction triangle of seek, believe, and perceive. And now we are perplexed, not knowing what to do. Warm greetings to everyone. I'm Pragyashree in grade 12, and I'm here to present the conclusions that I've drawn by pondering profoundly over certain things over and over for a pretty significant part of my life. Earlier, people used to believe things that are true. And then they started believing things not knowing if they are true. And finally ended up believing things that are false as well. Now, what should I believe? Should I even believe? What will life look like if I eliminate this word believe from my dictionary? What if I start believing things that only have an evidence to prove their existence? Oh no, then I'll be called an evidentialist. And certainly, these kinds of questions go round and round your minds to ultimately land you in a burnout state. And by the end of my talk, you will definitely find an answer to all these questions. And now, what should you do? First of all, why do you believe things? Because they give you comfort. If at all they go against your wish and will, then you'll obviously not believe them. And here ends your journey that you've kick-started in search of truth. Don't fall prey to the rhetoric. Be sure you put your feet in the right place and then stand firm. And as Gandhi said, to believe in something and not to live it is dishonest. And this is how our beliefs enter and become an inevitable part of our life. So it's better on your part to stop believing things whose existence you are not sure about, as belief and confidence without clarity can turn out to be a whopping disaster. But I'm not asking you to become an empiricist. Rather, perception seems to be a better alternative. And if this happens, the world will be free from the hot debate between theists and atheists and can get rid of all the vexed problems between various religions where one claims to be superior to the other. As a matter of fact, approximately only 0.56 billion people are neither theists nor atheists, and they don't believe in anything that they don't know. And this is as per the information provided by the CIA World Factbook. You might wonder, of what use it is for anyone to believe in something or not to believe in something? No. If that's what you think, then you're absolutely ignorant. Do you really know the power of beliefs? If you don't, then please take a look at all these pictures. This is the death compilation of a Nazi concentration camp. Hitler used a quasi-mythical racist philosophy to exploit the ancient hatred of Jews by Christians. It was Hitler's belief in Nazism that led to the genocide of the Jews. According to the Encyclopedia of Wars, out of 1,763 recorded historical conflicts, 123, or 6.98%, had religion as the primary cause. Matthew White's The Great Big Book of Horrible Things gives religion as the cause of 11 out of 100 deadliest atrocities. And what is religion? Just a belief system. Now, so what is the resolution? Do we have a solution to all these problems? Yeah, we do. Now, how to go about these things? We shall see. As 14-year-old Malala Yousafzai sat on a bus in the grounds of a school in Pakistan's Swat Valley, a gunman shot her in the head. After proudly claiming responsibility, the Taliban told the world that the teenage education activists' work represented a new chapter of obscenity. What is it? Obscenity, to be underlined within double quotes in bold letters. And we have to finish this chapter. And do you know what he referred to as obscenity? The education of girls. The very reason behind me standing here. And here is an instance of men who flew planes into buildings on 9/11. The terrorists who went on a murderous rampage in Mumbai. The Bali bombers all killed as many people as they could in the name of their religion. Atheists like Mao or Pol Pot have murdered millions in the name of political totalitarianism. Be it theism, atheism, or anything for that matter, most beliefs have always led to a catastrophe. And these are the ultimate consequences of willing suspension of disbelief. All these took place not just because of beliefs, But the actual root causes of these massacres were dysfunctional beliefs. We're living in a world of ideologies where capitalism, anarchism, conservatism, fascism, racism, fundamentalism, fanaticism, radicalism, and extremism stir up a hornet's nest. What is mankind doing? We talk about the era of artificial intelligence, leaving behind human intellect. And that's why some people have started erroneously translating the worst of conflicts as holy wars. Oh, come on, man. I just couldn't come to terms with it. What is a war? A state of conflict, hostility, or antagonism. Then how can a war be holy? Now, I'm not here to oppose your beliefs or discriminate against any particular religion. But my questions are very simple. Are you sure about the probity of your beliefs? Do you know everything about it, such that you have started believing it? Are you confident enough to say that your beliefs will only make the world a better place to live in? If that's so, then I have no issues, absolutely no issues. But if your answer is a no, then I think we have lost our marbles. Now, how do we get back our coherence? Perception. This will serve as the right option, as it is only concerned with difference in opinions. But here is the trap too. Perception and reality are two different things. Perception only depends upon an individual's understanding of things and circumstances, whereas truth is a reality. The eye sees only what the mind is prepared to comprehend. And that's why some people look at the stars, not knowing they're in a dyke, and some are penny wise and pound foolish. But perception does have something to do with reality. But there are possibilities where your perception may not be the other person's reality and thus may lead to a clash of opinions. And this can be best illustrated by a simple short story. Once in a classroom, a kid asked his teacher, "Is God as beautiful?" The teacher said, "Yes, she looks very beautiful." His next question was, "How many spouses does she have?" The teacher replied, "Many." As getting married to her was considered divine, being a curious guy, this kid came up with another question. He asked her, "Now, where is she?" The teacher responded, "She died at a young age, because of which now she's a goddess in heaven." And hearing this, the kid jumped up and exclaimed, "Yes, yahoo, now we got it. It's Marilyn Monroe." While another kid, who was sitting next to him, retorted, "No, it's Cleopatra." After all, it all depends on how we perceive things. What is 6 for one can be 9 for the other. Yet, we are far from reality. The curiosity to know things will arise only when you are ready to accept the fact that you don't know everything. With this dawning of realization, seeking begins. As Jaibel says, people should accept the feeling of not knowing where they're going. Because it is only when we are suspended in mid-air with no landing in sight that we force our wings to unravel and alas begin our flight. And as we fly, we still may not know where we are going, but the miracle lies in the unfolding of the wings. You may not know where you're going, but you know that as long as you spread your wings, the winds will carry you. And this is the only truth about belief, the only way to perceive things, and the only key to seeking. Now, I request you all to close your eyes, please. People who are present here, please to close your eyes. And picture yourself in the state of one of those Jews in the death compilation which I've showed you earlier. Malnourished, dying out of hunger, witnessing your dear one's slow death, people being poisoned in gas chambers and tortured in concentration camps, begging your enemies to help you end your life, the piles of corpses haunting you. Savage. Now open your eyes. It was just a six-lettered word called belief that led to the Holocaust of 6 million lives. Now you would know what it is to be oppressed by someone's beliefs. Now it's up to you to decide to seek, believe, or perceive. Let humanity be preached to the social animals. And dear listeners, here's my final articulation to wrap up this talk with a bang. Listen with ears wide open. Seek before believing, but don't believe before seeking. And learn to perceive the two. Believe things that are true. Perceive things that are known. And seek the unknown. Hope my talk was not an esoteric philosophy. It's time for me to bid a bye with gratitude, longing to meet seekers in the future. Thank you.